voice is a little rough today, so you guys all have to...
This is Father Jim Korda. On behalf of your Catholic friends and neighbors in the Diocese of Youngstown, I invite you to join us for this celebration of the Holy Mass.
There was a man who walked in the storm, caught in between the waves and the lightning, sharing his bread with those cast aside, healing by touch the lost and the dying, sending us forth, he says, to his friends, I am for you, I am for you, I am for you to the end. There is a world that waits in the womb, there is a hope unborn God is burying. Though the powers of death prowl the night, there is a day our God is preparing. Sing round the fire to wake in the dawn. I am for you. I am for you. I am for you, we are one. I am for you, I am for you, I am for you, we are one.
Good morning. We welcome all of you who are joining us here at our chapel at St. Paul Monastery, as well as those who are joining us over our ecumenical channel here in Northeast Ohio. Today we celebrate the Feast of the Ascension of the Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory.
Let us pray. Gladden us with holy days, Almighty God, and make us rejoice with devout thanksgiving, for the ascension of Christ your Son is our exaltation. And where the head has gone before in glory, the body is called to follow in hope. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. He presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized by the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He answered them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons that the Father has established by his authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky, as he was going, suddenly two men dressed in white robes stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking up into the sky? This Jesus who has been taken up from you into heaven will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord is kind. And all my being, bless God's name. Bless the Lord and forget not God's benefits. The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord is kind and merciful. God pardons all your iniquities and comforts your sorrows, redeems your life from destruction, and crowns you with kindness. The Lord is kind and merciful. The
our God, slow to anger, abounding in kindness. The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord is kind and merciful.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I, a prisoner for the Lord, urge you to live in a manner worthy of the call you have received, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another through love, striving to preserve the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace, one body and one Spirit, as you were also called to the one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God, one Father for all. But grace was given to each of us according to the measure of Christ's gift. And he gave some as apostles, others as prophets, others as evangelists, others as pastors and teachers, to equip the holy ones for the work of the ministry, for building up the body of Christ, until we all attain the unity of faith and knowledge of the Son of God to mature manhood, to the extent of the full stature of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. From the whole conclusion of the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel to every creature. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. Whoever does not believe will be condemned. These signs will accompany those who believe in my name. They will drive out demons. They will speak new languages. They will pick up serpents with their hands, and if they drink any deadly thing, it will not harm them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover." So then the Lord Jesus, after he spoke to them, was taken up into heaven and took a seat at the right hand of God. But they went forth and preached everywhere, while the Lord worked with them and confirmed the word through accompanying signs. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Just want to let you know there are a couple of chairs sitting on the side if you'd like to have a chair instead of standing. Just a few announcements and an update on where we are at St. Paul Monastery. First of all, you have all heard from our governor of the state of Ohio that on June 2nd, the mask mandate will be rescinded, so we will not have to wear masks in public. However, if you go to a business or a restaurant that wants you to wear a mask, you have to wear a mask. And of course, if you're going to a nursing home or facility of that nature, you also have to wear a mask. Now, we don't know what that means for us because we are waiting for the Ohio bishops to decide what they're going to give us as far as guidelines. And once they give us the guidelines, that will give us a clue as to how we're going to do all of that mask wearing as we gather here every Sunday. The only thing that the bishops have reminded us is that on the weekend of June 5th and 6th, which would be after the mask mandate is lifted, is that the obligation of attending Sunday Mass will return. In other words, we have been dispensed from obliging ourselves to be here for the Sunday Mass during this whole year because of the pandemic. Well, that dispensation is going to be rescinded, and so you're going to be required. But it's like talking to the choir, because I know all of you guys come all the time. But if people are asking, that's what it's going to be. The second thing I like to mention is one of our brothers in this community, Brother Aloysius Malella, who is 92 years of age, will be 93 next month. Unfortunately, we've had to move him to a assisted living facility because he had Alzheimer's, and the care he needs is beyond the care that we can give here. Oftentimes, you might have found him here in the front pew. Most of the time, he went to the 7 o'clock Mass. He is at Omni West assisted living facility on Vesto Road in Youngstown off of Meridian Road, and certainly if you'd like to go visit him, you can. I'd say give him a couple of weeks. He's still getting settled in. I had a few rough days at the beginning, but I think he's doing well now, and they do have specific days and times that you can come and visit, so make sure that you do that if you'd like to go visit with him. The third thing I like to announce is that we in the Society of St. Paul in the United States, we are now considered a region. Now, that doesn't mean anything to you, so I'm going to try to explain to you in very simple language on how this is done. In our country, for many years, we were a province, and that meant we had a lot of people. We were up to 40, 45 people at one time in our province. We had four or five houses at one time, and so we would have a provincial superior and four guys who made up his council, and they would make decisions on our ministry and the communities and the movement of personnel and everything we needed to do in terms of our province. Well, 5 years ago, for the last 5 years, we have been a delegation of the general government. So Father Tony Bautista was the delegate appointed by our superior general, and he governed all that we were doing. Now, he may talk with us, consult with us, get ideas, but all the decisions had to come from Rome. So when they decided they were going to make me superior of this community, in the past it would have been the provincial. The last 5 years, it would have been from the Superior General who made that appointment. Father Tony's term is over, and so now we had a consultation via Zoom with our general government. All of us individually were able to speak with them, and they took all our consultations together, and they decided to make us a region. And the only difference between a province and a region is the size. We only have a couple of communities, and there's only 14 of us, and so we're really not large enough anymore to be a province. So we are a region, and so we have a regional superior, and in a little bit, we're going to have an assembly where all the members of our region will come together, and then we will elect two counselors that will work with our regional superior, and our regional superior is appointed for 3 years, and we're glad to have our regional superior is Brother Marco Bogarelli, who's a member of our community. Yes, yes. Oftentimes he sits up here, but you know, because our singing group took all the good chairs, we had to sit in the back. So that's where he is. But prayers for him and prayer for us as we move forward over the next 3 years. Today we celebrate the Feast of the Ascension, and if you go to the Gospels and the Ascension story is like the story of the crucifixion, which is the story of the resurrection. They're all different. If you go to the Gospel of Matthew, there is no Ascension story. He just says, go and preach in my name and carry on the gospel message, and that's it. There's no ascending, there's no viewing, there's no movement of Jesus whatsoever. Then you go to the Gospel of Luke. Luke has two ascensions. In the end of the gospel, well, first of all, in Matthew, he ascends from Galilee. In Luke, he ascends from Bethany, so it's a whole different place, and that's in the gospel of Luke. But then Luke has a second one, that Jesus is on earth for 40 days before he ascends, and that's in the Acts of the Apostles. Then you go to Mark. Mark today has the ascension happening on Easter Sunday. And so there's a few appearances. He comes and gives them the commission to go forth and proclaim the message, and then he ascends into heaven. If you go to the Gospel of John, he has everything happening on Easter Sunday. Jesus rises from the dead. He goes around meeting different people, meets with them, and before he ascends, he breathes his Holy Spirit upon them, and that is Pentecost. And then he has ascension, and off he goes to heaven. So for us, it really doesn't matter when it happened, where it happened, and how it happened, but why it happened. And that's what's important for us, because the first thing we reflect upon in the ascension is that Jesus Christ has left us, and he has gone to heaven, and he has gone to heaven in his resurrected body. If you remember those stories in the resurrection, many people didn't recognize him because his body was changed. It was transformed. It was a resurrected body. Yes, he might have had the wounds from his crucifixion, but some people didn't recognize him. But his resurrected body returns to heaven, but as we see in today's gospel, his resurrected body is with us. We are the body of Christ. That was what our opening prayer said, that we, as the head has gone ahead of us, we as the body are going ahead. So we are the resurrected body. We are the ones that are carrying on the presence of Jesus Christ, and he is with us in his Eucharist. He is with us in his body and blood. He is with us in his word. He is with us in our lives. And so he has promised to be with us because he has gone to heaven. So we need him to go to heaven so that he can send his presence to be with us, to be the body of Christ in our world today. The second thing we are reminded is Jesus Christ is telling us this is the way that we can go to heaven. We believe in the resurrection of the body. We believe that we will get to heaven. We believe that we will be in a resurrected body, so all our aches and all our pains and all the aging process that is all of us will be gone by the time we get to heaven. And so what that challenges us to do is how do we live our life here to make sure we get to heaven? Are we bringing love? Are we bringing concern? Are we bringing healing? Are we bringing the message of God? Or are we bringing war? Are we bringing hate? We are bringing evil into our lives. Because if that's what we're doing, we ain't going to get to heaven. We're going to go to hell. And we don't want to go to hell. I haven't been there, but I don't want to go to hell. I want to go to heaven. So that means it's going to challenge me on how I live my life, and that's what we need to do. Let's do things that are going to be blessed by the Lord, be judged by the Lord, and know that we are giving the Lord's presence to one another. And that's the third point that we are to reflect upon, is that we have been commissioned to share the message. Go and tell the message of Jesus Christ. Go bring healing. Go baptize people in the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Let them know. So tell the story of Jesus Christ. Tell them what we know. Tell them the stories. Okay, we might not get all the stories correct. The Gospels didn't get all the stories correct. But you can tell the story, and how has the Lord affected each one of us? And that's what we are to reflect upon in the Feast of the Ascension, because we're only going to have one more week of Easter, a great celebration of the Easter season, and then we return back to what we call ordinary times, ordinary lives. So today we are reminded that Jesus has gone to heaven with his resurrected body and challenges us to be the resurrected body today, shows us that we too can have the resurrection of our own bodies into heaven if we work hard on doing and fulfilling the teaching of Jesus Christ, and then we are to tell others how important Jesus Christ is in our everyday lives. Let us stand together now and share our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us now turn to God with our needs and the needs of our neighbors all around the world.
For the church, that empowered by the Holy Spirit, we may faithfully give witness to the gospel and continue Christ's mission of bringing hope and healing to all, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who face the future with apprehension and uncertainty, that God will enlighten their path and give them peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who work to bring food to our tables, that God will bless them with seasonable weather and a bountiful harvest, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the homebound, that the Lord will protect them, renew their spirits, receive them to wholeness, and strengthen all caregivers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the pandemic, that God's healing love will restore the sick to health, make the vaccines effective, and curtail the spread of the virus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And as we pray this Mass, let us remember Darn Sarcano. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving and merciful God, guide us in bearing witness to you in the way we treat each other, in the way we treat the stranger, in the way we treat all people. Hear the prayers we make through your Son, who sits at your right hand in glory now and forever. Amen.
This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me, and I'm desperate for you. And I'm lost without you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. We offer sacrifice now in supplication, O Lord, to honor the wondrous ascension of your Son. Grant, we pray, that through this most holy exchange, we too may rise up to the heavenly realms through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended today to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and us, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope and David our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. Paul, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. An act of spiritual communion for those unable to be with us today. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
taught my heart to fear and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy rains. Unending love, amazing grace. The earth shall soon dissolve like snow, the sun forbear to shine, but God, who called me, He
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who allow those on earth to celebrate divine mysteries, grant, we pray, that Christian hope may draw us onward to where our nature is united with you, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Again, I thank all of you for being here at the chapel at St. Paul Monastery. Those joining us over our ecumenical channel here in Northeast Ohio, I thank our musicians, thank our reader, and have a wonderful day. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
People of God.